Hey guys, happy Wednesday. I am so excited that you guys decided to tune in with us tonight as we continue our lesson, DIY, do it yourself, where we're talking all about forgiveness. Now, forgiveness is an awesome lesson, a very important lesson that Jesus talks about in the Bible. So let's dive into today's lesson as we talk all about forgiveness.
Party people, I'm Erica, and actually, I'm planning a party to celebrate fixing up my new apartment! All month long, we've been talking about forgiveness. Forgiveness is deciding that someone who has wronged you doesn't have to pay. Forgiveness can clean up some pretty bad messes, which is exactly what I've been doing around this place. So before we get this party started, I'm going to show you one last do-it-yourself hack involving my new kitchen table. My friend Chris volunteered to help me move it into the apartment, which was great of him until the incident. It was Chris's idea to turn the table sideways to get it in the door. I told him it wouldn't work, but he did it anyways and broke one of the legs. So guess what? I was right and he was wrong. Now look at my table. So it was Chris's fault that I have to spend my whole afternoon showing you how to make a table more level. Thanks a lot, Chris. Guess who's not getting invited to the party now? It's you, Chris. Let's do this thing. Huh, that was pretty easy, actually. Let's check this out. Test one. Test two. Yay! Last but not least, test three. Oh man. Don't think that lets you off the hook, Chris. You're still missing out on my party. Today's story is about a guy who wasn't so sure he wanted to party. My party's going to be great, by the way. We're going to have music and games and snacks. And although Chris would usually be the one to bring the snacks, plus he plays the best games and picks really good music. Ugh! If Chris isn't invited, maybe I'll be the one who misses out.
I had no hope for tomorrow. Felt so much pressure, yes, I thought I would crack. But now there's no looking back. I'm moving forward, cause I know I got my armor now. No fear, no doubt, can't shoot me down, yeah. I got my armor now, no fear, no doubt. Gonna shoot me down, 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 down. My soul is untouchable because you've already won me. My victory is not in this flesh and bone. It's in the cross and I know nobody's taking it from me. I got my armor now, no fear, no doubt, can't shoot me down, yeah. I got my armor now, no fear, no doubt, gonna shoot me down, 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 down.
No matter what the world may say or what they do, I am.
like a child. I give you an inch and you take me a mile. I feel the wind rush and the thunder roll. 2 feet on the water, only one way to go. Yeah. I don't gotta be afraid no more, no. 'Cause I know you up and through the storm. I'm more than just a talker.
It's 66 books of history, stories, letters, and poetry that fit together to form God's one big story. The epic adventure of how he created us and loves us so much that he made a way to rescue us. As we travel through the Bible, from Genesis to Revelation, we discover people who met God and found their lives changed forever. And now for an amazing story inspired by the book of Luke. Chapter 15, verses 21 through 32.
When Jesus wanted to share something important, he often told a story to explain what he meant. Now, one day, the religious leaders were grumbling because Jesus chose to bring in outcasts and people who did things wrong.
He hangs out with sinners
and even, like, eats with them.
Jesus knew their hearts. These men thought they were better than everyone else. So he told them the story of a man and his two sons. Now the youngest son asked for his share of his father's money, and he took off. He spent his money on parties and all other stuff. But then the money ran out, and he ended up at a miserable job feeding pigs while he himself starved. Desperate, the young son returned home, planning on begging for mercy and working as a servant. Instead, his father welcomed him with open arms and even planned a party for his lost son in his honor. Ultimately, seemed like a happy ending. But Jesus wasn't finished with the story yet.
The older son was in the field. When he came near the house, he heard music and dancing.
If Jesus were to tell that story to us today, it might sound something like this. The older brother, let's call him Will. He spent the entire day working hard, perhaps plowing up the packed dirt on a brand new field.
Come on, Bessie. Just one more row. Gotta finish before the light goes.
As the sun slipped behind the hill, Will finished breaking the dirt on his last long row.
I just need some water and a quiet meal and bed.
Will trudged slowly back to the house and left Bessie in the barn with a bag of oats.
If my slacker brother hadn't run off, I wouldn't have to work so hard.
As Will neared the house, he was surprised to see the lights blazing from every window.
What is going on?
Will stopped, trying to make sense of all the activity and the music. Then, the back door opened. One of the servants stepped outside to throw out a bowl of scrap, and she turned to go back inside.
Wait.
The servant paused.
What's happening?
It's just the party for your brother.
The what for my what?
You haven't heard? Your brother showed up this afternoon. Your dad had the fattest calf killed and roasted to celebrate. He is so thankful Jake's safe.
A party? My dad is throwing a party?
I'll let the family know you're back.
What? No, no, I am not coming in.
The servant wrinkled her nose.
Whew. You want someone to run you a bath first?
Leave me alone.
The servant hurried back inside. Will paced as his exhaustion vanished and anger coursed through his veins.
I work all day, every day. Has Dad ever thrown a party for me?
Will stalked back and forth, fuming as the back door opened up again. His father hurried out.
Will, here you are.
Well, look at that. You decided to remember I exist.
Your brother is back. He's okay.
Well, that is just fantastic.
We're all celebrating, but it's not complete without you. Come on inside.
Will turned and looked directly at his father, eyes blazing.
All these years, I've worked nonstop for you. I've done every single thing you asked, and you never even given me a goat to have a party with my friends.
You never said you wanted.
This son of yours runs away with your money and wastes it like a fool. Then he shows up and you roast a fatted calf and throw a giant shindig.
Will's father sighed, took a deep breath, and looked Will directly in the face.
My son, you are always with me. Everything I have is yours, but we had to celebrate and be glad. This brother of yours was dead for all we knew. And now he's alive again. He was lost, and now he is found.
Look, I'm real tired. I plowed the entire north field.
Thank you.
I think I'll just go to bed.
Won't you come into the party? Just for a few minutes.
Will hesitated. He could see the people through the window, dancing, eating, full of joy. The light and the music called them.
Please, Will.
We don't know if the older brother ever listened to his father. We don't know if he ever forgave his younger brother. We don't know if he chose to go and enjoy the party. But what we do know is that if he stayed outside, he missed out on many good things.
You need to be careful with that stuff, all right?
I am being careful. See, look. I have gloves. Do you have gloves? Wear your gloves. I've got gloves.
Okay, but you're not wearing the gloves.
You say potato. I say whatever.
Okay, seriously though, the glue in your hand, it sticks to anything instantly.
Oh, so I know. Really... Trust me. I will never forget the cat incident.
Oh, I don't think the cat will either.
Its fur will grow back eventually, okay?
Okay.
Now here, hold these.
Okay, why?
Because.
Good answer.
Now.
Ha! Why?
See, look, because their hair, it's so soft, feel it.
Oh, super right? Soft, yeah. Oh, sorry, here, let me get that.
No, I got it, don't worry about it.
All right, wait, you're.
You know what, it's no problem. I'm just gonna pull it off like this. Here we go. And. One.
You're
don't worry, not an issue. I got some glue remover down here. I'm just gonna go grab. Bread it! A little help. Bennett!
Yeah, just a second.
Help! Where are you going? Bennett? Bennett! Bennett, where are you going? Can I help me? Ooh, what is that? Can that get me out? What is... No!
I'll help you after this.
No!
Smile.
Don't understand. How is it that complicated?
Look, just because it's your way doesn't mean it has to be my way.
But
that's all I'm saying.
It's not my way. There's a right and a wrong way to do things, and clearly you're on the wrong side of the road,
mister. That's like saying there's a right and a wrong way to tie your shoes.
There is a right way and a wrong way to tie your shoes.
If your shoes are tied, it's the right way.
Hey, guys, we're rolling.
Welcome to the So-and-So Show. I'm Brandon.
And I'm Lawson. And we're glad you decided to watch today.
We have an exciting show lined up. Isn't that right, Lawson?
That's right, Brandon. So exciting.
You're not going to let this go, are you?
I don't have the slightest idea what you're talking about.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Fine.
Fine.
As we continue to talk about forgiveness this month,
I want you to admit that you're wrong.
See, I knew you weren't going to let this go. You're being ridiculous.
I'm being ridiculous. Why don't you let them decide who's being ridiculous?
Oh, they're just going to agree with me.
We'll see about that. Huh. Breaking news, Brandon, current co-host of The So-and-So Show, has been identified as a non-toilet paper replacer.
Hey!
Though some of his fans will be shocked by this incendiary information, Brandon has been a longtime follower of the belief that placing a new role on the sink is good enough. We can also exclusively reveal that on the rare occasion when he actually does replace the toilet paper, Brandon places the paper with the end going underneath. I understand that these accusations against the longtime host of The So-and-So Show will cause some to wonder if they truly knew Brandon at all. This has been a breaking news report. Thanks for watching. Now back to your normally scheduled program already in progress.
Really?
You asked for it.
Okay, you're right, Lawson. You're right.
I am?
Yeah, I should have replaced the toilet paper after it was used up. That's the courteous thing to do.
Thank you. You know what? I forgive you for being so uncourteous.
Thank you.
But what about that other thing?
I will not apologize for how I install the toilet paper. There's no right or wrong way to hang the toilet paper.
Au contraire, mon frère.
There isn't. And I'll prove it to you.
What do you... Brandon, what's this?
It's another way to hang toilet paper.
Oh.
It's also a game.
Ooh.
All right, so in our hands, we have a bunch of rubber bands.
Yes.
Right, and what we're gonna do is we're going to shoot the rubber bands at the toilet paper, trying to rip it at the seams. The first one of us who can make two aluminum cans drop to the ground wins the game, all right? Mm-hmm. And we gotta do it blindfolded. Is that okay with you?
Yeah, actually, it sounds fun.
All right. Blindfolds on. Okay, ready? On the count of three. One, two, three.
Anything? Ow!
I heard something.
It's me.
Oh, that was a little far off.
it hits your finger on the point of exit.
Do you not know how to shoot a rubber band?
I skipped this part of my childhood. I went straight to division. Ow!
I heard a can.
Did it not fall?
Woo!
What? Wait, I need more rubber band.
That's just one. That's just one. Oops. Sorry, cameraman.
How am I not hitting anything?
It's like you've never done this before.
Cool. Huh.
Booyah!
What? How did I not hit anything?
Woohoo! Well?
That was actually fun.
It's Bible story time with Kellen!
Hey, guys!
Hi, Kellen!
You seem to be in a good mood.
I know, isn't it crazy? What story do you have for us today?
Okay, so last time I told you the first part of Jesus' parable of the prodigal son. Remember this?
Previously on My Two Sons.
Father, I want my inheritance.
Oh? How much of it?
Wait, let me think. Oh, that's right. All of it!
Better not be eating that slop. That's high quality slop. Feed the pigs.
My son was dead. But he's alive again. He was lost. But now, he is found.
You remember that?
Sort of.
It's mostly familiar.
Great. Jesus told the story of a father who had two sons. The younger son left and wasted his share of his father's money. The older son stayed home. When the younger son returned home, the father forgave him. And that's where we pick up our story.
I can't wait!
Cool. Now here's part two of My Two Sons.
As time moves on, so do the lives of my two sons.
Where are you going with all that food?
Your younger brother has come home. Your father is throwing a welcome home party in his honor.
He's what?
As you can tell, the older brother was not thrilled. He refused to attend the party, so his father went to find him.
Why are you not at the party?
Why am I not at the party? Why am I not at the party? Well, let me think. All these years, I have worked like a slave for you, and I have done this and I have done that, and you haven't so much as thrown me and my friends a tea party. You know, Dad, me and my friends, we like parties too.
My son, you are always with me.
But then my little brother leaves and he throws all your money away and he comes back and you give him a full-blown carnival.
My son. Everything I have is yours. But don't you see? We had to celebrate his return.
Why, Dad? Why?
This little brother of yours was dead, but now he's alive. He was lost, but now he's found.
That's the end?
Yeah, that's the ending Jesus gave us. Did the older brother forgive his younger brother like his father did? We don't know. I think Jesus told the story that way because he wanted us to put ourselves in the older brother's shoes. Would you be willing to forgive someone even if they may not deserve it? When you forgive, you're like the father in the story and our father in heaven. When you don't, you could be like the older brother and you could miss out on a great party. Are you okay?
I got left at a party once. My mommy didn't pick me up. It was so scary.
Soap operas just do this to him.
No, it's not that. I just forgive you for not putting the toilet paper on.
Oh. And I forgive you for yelling at me for not putting the toilet paper on.
I'll just see you guys next time then.
Bye, Kelly!
Yeah. Bye.
I have no toilet paper. It's really good. Look at it. Thank you.
Reveal the question. Do the thing. What do you lose if you don't forgive?
You can lose so much. Friendships, joy. I would have missed out on your awesome toilet paper game, Brandon, so thank you.
You're welcome. I'm glad you're starting to rethink the whole toilet paper has to go over the top thing.
No, I still disagree with you on that one, but we can disagree and still be friends, right?
Absolutely.
And besides, I thought of an even better way to install toilet paper.
Ooh, do tell. Wow! Hey, we'll see you guys next week for a brand new show.
Bye,
guys.
We'll
see how this baby works. I'm dizzy. Oh, the room is spinning. Why did I do that?
The older brother and Jesus' story totally missed out. Being right was way more important to him than repairing the relationships with his father and brother. The father, on the other hand, forgave his son and threw a big party! Forgiveness is something we should celebrate. Think about it. In the beginning, God decorated for the biggest party ever when he made paradise for his people. But over time, people got further and further and further away from paradise. So God sent Jesus. Because of what Jesus did for us, we can be forgiven. Jesus even said that when someone turns to God, there's great joy in heaven. Maybe like a party! When you forgive someone in your heart, that's worth celebrating. I mean, forgiveness can save relationships. It can even make someone else feel like they matter. And forgiveness can take the weight off your shoulders too. But when you hold grudges and you don't forgive, you can miss out on all that stuff. That's why the one thing to remember today is this. When you don't forgive, you miss out. So, of course, I'm going to forgive my friend Chris for breaking my table even though I was right and he was wrong. I don't want to miss out on our party. And I definitely don't want to miss out on our friendship. That's way more important to me than being right. Welp, that's all for now. I've got to go get ready for a party. See you around.
Wow, what an awesome story on forgiveness. I am so grateful that we serve a God who forgives. Hey guys, if you enjoyed tonight, I wanna encourage you to hop on our YouTube. Saturday at 6 p.m., we're gonna be launching our weekend service that we have produced together. It's gonna be really fun. Now we have games, we have skits, we have worship. We're gonna have a cool message. Guys, you're gonna love it as we continue this message on forgiveness. If you know someone who's not having church or they're not having a live stream, hey, share the link with them, get all your friends, gather around the TV, gather around the computer, and have church with us as we continue this story on forgiveness. Hey guys, also I wanna encourage you to keep sending us your daily family challenges. It's been really cool, all the pictures and all the videos that we've been getting so far. You guys are awesome. Be blessed, keep tuning in, and we will see you guys this weekend on our service online. Have a good one.